In today's video, we're talking about what your mindset is after losing your sight. What's up, VIPs? Derek here, back with another video. And you know, when you lose your sight, your mind kind of takes a shift. And sometimes it happens really quickly, and sometimes it can take a long, long time. But what mindset I'm talking about is the difference between seeing yourself as sighted versus seeing yourself as visually impaired. By the way, if you're new around here, my name is Derek, and I help people just like you to discover life after sight loss. Here you'll find product reviews, life advice, encouragement, how-tos, and so much more. So if that sounds good to you, I'd love for you to consider subscribing, liking, following, and all that other good stuff so that you don't miss another single video. Now, what do I mean by seeing yourself as sighted versus visually impaired? Well, when I lost my sight at 18 years old, I had always seen myself as a sighted person. I didn't really know that at the time because sighted people don't think of themselves as sighted, but you know, that's how I saw myself. I was a sighted person. And then when I had to start dealing with life with a visual impairment, it was difficult because I still saw myself as a sighted person. I've spoken with lots of people, and they all kind of have this shift that happens at some point. And again, it can happen soon or later, or who knows when. But it goes from seeing themselves as a sighted person versus seeing themselves as a visually impaired person. One time I was talking to a young man who was about my age when he lost his sight. And I asked him, do you see yourself as a sighted person with not very good vision? Or do you see yourself as a visually impaired person with decent remaining vision? And his answer was a sighted person with not very good vision. And so when you see yourself as that, that means something to you versus seeing yourself as a VIP with remaining vision that's okay. So for example, I ask people, well, when you go to the store, can you make it through the store on your own? Well, yeah, I can make it through the store. I can get to the back, to the front. I could probably find that way in and out. Okay, great. But can you find anything on the shelves? Well, that would be a lot more difficult. I'd have to have a lot of magnifiers or people's help or things like that. You see, the difference is a sighted person would go in that store and find the things on the shelf, walk out of the store, never need any help. A visually impaired person would need some assistance to get around the store. Now, I know what you might be saying. Hold on, Derek, are you saying sighted people are better than us as VIPs? No, not at all. What I'm saying is we have to shift our mind a little bit and get to the point where we're willing to accept the fact that we are visually impaired. It's not a bad thing. It's just something that, you know, takes a little time to get there. I can't tell you when it happened for me necessarily, but at some point I just started to realize that I am a visually impaired person. I have enough of a visual impairment that it affects my everyday life. I need some extra assistance. I need voiceover turned on my iPhone. I need bump dots on my microwave and flat surfaces in my house. I need special apps on my phone so that I can, you know, read documents and things like that. When I walk out and about in the neighborhood, I'm probably going to need a white cane for identification purposes at the very least, and to find different obstacles and things like that. When I go to the store, I can't just pick things up off the shelf. I need some help. And when I check out at that store, I'm going to need some help with that little, you know, checker thing and punching the numbers in your car. I need some help. And that's okay. There's nothing wrong with any of that. Being visually impaired does not define you as a whole, but admitting it and being willing to accept it means that, okay, I do know that my life is now different than it was before. I think that's the key component, is knowing that your life is different. It's not bad. It's not negative. I mean, maybe there's some negative things, but it's just how it is now. So accepting the fact that you're visually impaired and shifting from a mindset of saying, no, I'm a sighted person with not very good vision, versus being a visually impaired person with, you know, okay residual vision. That, I know that doesn't seem like a big deal, and it's like, well, what does it matter what I think about myself? As long as I'm doing good and being independent, at the end of the day, really, it doesn't really matter, I guess. As long as you're living your life, you're happy, you're excited, you're going out, you're doing whatever. It's, you go do you and just do that. But for so many people, they struggle with this idea, and I think it's because they have not gotten a hold of this mindset shift. And so they're really stuck in this time frame of being sighted with not very good vision. One good example of this is when I first started losing my sight and we were going to visit doctor's offices. And we went to an office I'd never been to before, and it was in a city I'd never been to before. And so I was walking down the sidewalk, and again, I'm a sighted person. My vision isn't great, but I'm doing fine, whatever. And my parents were behind me, and I walked up to the corner, and I kind of looked to left and right like you would, you know, when crossing the street. And there was this car that was just right coming in my blind spot, and I couldn't see it, and I started to go, and my parents were like, wait, and the car was like, hold on, and you know, and it wasn't a huge deal. It wasn't like going 90 or anything going to hit me. But I realized in that moment, I can't see that car. That's an issue. And so crossing the street became a much bigger challenge than it was before. Fast forward years later, and I was crossing another street. It's a very busy street, and I did not have my cane. And I thought, no, I'm doing okay. I'll be fine. I'll just listen to the traffic. And I didn't almost get hit necessarily, but there was a car that had to slow pretty quick. And I was like, I need my cane, you know? I'm not a sighted person. People that see me might see a sighted person, but I'm not sighted. I have enough of a visual impairment to impede me crossing the street. So I need that cane so the people notice. And again, those are just little things that help me know that being visually impaired isn't necessarily a bad thing, but it's important to kind of recognize. So if you're in that place today where you're saying, no, I'm sighted. My vision's not just not great or whatever. I get it. But if your vision is such that it impedes on your life every single day and you need a little assistance to get through certain things, bump dots and screen readers and assistive technology and all that, if you need that kind of stuff, you're probably visually impaired. And hear me, there's nothing wrong with that. That's perfectly fine. But having that mindset and admitting it and accepting it, though it can be a long process, is so important and will help you move forward in your life as a VIP. So my question for you today is this. It's the question I asked that young man. Do you consider yourself a sighted person with not very good vision, or a visually impaired person or blind person who has okay residual vision or maybe no vision at all? You know, it's all about our mindset. So I want to hear what you think about this topic. I'd love to hear from you, and I know others would as well, so let me know in the comments below. Hey, if you like this video, if you found it helpful, make sure to show your support by giving it a big thumbs up and sharing it out with somebody that you know. And if you're watching this on YouTube, make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so that you don't miss another single video. Thanks so much for watching wherever you are, and until next time, remember that sight loss isn't the end, it's just the beginning. My name's Derek Daniel from LifeAfterSightLoss.com, and I'll see you in the next one.